2013 64th Annual Holiday Fine Arts and Crafts Festival. Now, that's a mouthful.
Yeah, it is.
And you've been very busy. Tell me what people can expect this weekend.
You're going to basically find the best in both fine art and the best in juried crafts. Actually, the juried craftsmen, we're basically master craftsmen. And why that is because we had taken our product to a total, we're constantly educating ourselves and taking it to a whole nother entity and still keeping the integrity of the one-of-a-kind pieces of work that we do.
What type of crafts can people expect to see and to perhaps purchase?
Well, anywhere from jewelry, we have quite a bit of jewelers, all the way to, and I have a few pieces on the table, we have anywhere from flower cutting, which is a piece on the table, and Bill's actually hooked up on the earrings, and that is one, in fact, that is one of our jewelers, and here's my wedding ring, which I lost my other one, and you can expect men's jewelry at the show as well, and all the way from the primitive, which is a piece that I do, all the way to the fine arts.
Pottery, right?
This is kind of interesting. Here is a piece of salt glass pottery, okay, which we have one artist do. This is a piece from one of the students, which we have KU college students set up as well, which we help them. And this is taking that salt glass glaze to a contemporary piece, which is a vase. So that's one thing you can expect what is at the show.
And you have a lot of dedicated artists. Tell me who's going to be there.
Well, Louise Mahaffey, again, I'm going to plug her book. She'll have her book there. We have Pat Oxenford, who does toll painting. We have Kim Stromero, who is really a fine artist in jewelry. We have tinware. We have, of course, clay. We have froctoring. We have froctoring both in a piece that's here, which is a three-dimensional froctor, but then my wife does froctors in plant material, which is the other piece on the table as well. So we have fine artists. We have Gerald Putt, who I think he won about 11 Pennsylvania Duck stamps, and that is oil painting or acrylic painting. So we have all the way from that to very contemporary Wilfrida Axsmith. She does her work on silk, which is fabric, which is clothing that she designs. And she does all the coloring and patterns and everything on the silk. So it's a full array from clothing to nuts. Because there is one gentleman there, and he makes lawn art out of silverware and other parts of metals, and they're all funky colors. So it's taking that part all the way to the clothing part.
Great. Now, and this is the Holiday Fine Arts Craft Festival, so, you know, it's very special kickoff to the holiday season. Tell me a little bit about where it's at and the admission price.
The show is at Kutztown University, which is in the Michael Opaque Field House. If you go on rbcrafts.org, you will see the TomTom address on your apps, and we have 90 different artisans, and we have live music, which from Acoustic Roadshow does. We have a cafe setting, and we have food. So it's a full venue as to one-stop shopping, and so, filling your tummy too.
Right, it sounds like a great family event.
It is very much so. And we're there. You can ask this particular artist, well, a question. You can ask any of us because we're the designers. It's one of a kind, and we are the designers of all the way from contemporary to primitive to flat work, which is two-dimensional art, to photography. We have photographers also as well.
Great. Well, I'm sure there'll be lots of patrons out this weekend at the festival to support.
We're looking forward to it.